I have to eat from the drunkard mouth. I want you to hide me. Don't argue with God. Anything he tells you, just do it. Touch not the Lord's anointed, nor do his prophet. I'm too anointed to be disappointed. Somebody said the angel of the Lord encampeth round about them that fear him to deliver them. Hide me, Lord. So Jonathan helped David to hide.
Yes, we want to take this opportunity to invite 1,000 Jamaicans to join us. Portmore St. Catherine, 18 West Tradeway, Portmore Town Center, Mega Convention, Easter Monday, the 18th of April, 9:30 a.m. I want you to come on out as we pray for Jamaica, land we love. Too much crime, too much murder, too much corruption. We've got to seek God. If my people who are called by my name humble themselves and pray, I will heal the land. Come on out and join us, Jamaica, 1,000 strong, to pray over the nation. It's another ball out, Easter Monday, the 18th of April, Breakthrough Deliverance Ministry, Portmore. Will you be there? Looking forward to seeing you. Prove me now, says the Lord of hosts, if I will not open the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing. How many ready to be blessed? How many ready for the windows of heaven to open and God begin to pour out his blessing upon you? Welcome to the Breakthrough Deliverance Ministry, reaching out to you with another powerful release, a message that can change your life, change your finances, change your status, change your situation. As you watch, I want you to take this message serious as we outline how heaven can open on your behalf, how the glory of God can touch down over your life, how, praise God, you can see God at work and see Jesus as he sits at the right hand of God watching you, even as you go through difficulties in life. Let's tell you something. Your tithe can open the windows of heaven and pour you out great blessing that you don't have room enough to receive it. Praise God. Welcome to the Breakthrough. I'm excited, and I hope you're excited too, for one more week of telecast, and I know you're going to be blessed. Call somebody up and tell them watch the Breakthrough. But before that, I want to take the opportunity to invite you to join us for our divine worship today here in Mandeville, Manchester, Portmore St. Catherine at 18 West Tradeway, Portmore Town Center, Huntspan on the Bustamante Highway in Clarendon, and of course in Top Hill, St. Elizabeth. I want you to join us every Monday right here for Mega Fast, Portmore at 10 a.m. on a Tuesday, and of course Huntspan on a Thursday. You got to come and be a part of the great Breakthrough PhD Ministries. I'm not going to waste any time. I want to take you into the full message. Of course, it's a powerful release, and if you watch, your life will never be the same. I promise you. We'll come back to pray for you. Be blessed as you watch. Soon come back.
Lithian as a neighbor, they're going to see me. They never saw me going in, but they're going to see me coming out. Because while I was in, I paid my dues. I sat at the feet of God. I did what I was asked to do. And now God is bringing you out. You think people not going to see you? Lift your hand and say, neighbor, when God will bring you out, and I don't seek, because your enemy... They got to see you and praise your God. Which one of you right now, after all the hell you've been through, and you remember where God has taken you from? You can lift your hand and just say, I love you, Lord, for your mercy. All my day I've been held in your, every moment that I wait, until I show up, I will sing of the goodness. Y'all mean a way you don't know me can't sing. Well, yeah, yeah, yeah. All my I mean, I have nothing for nobody sing.
All life you have been so, so good. And every breath that I am able,
oh, I will sing
of the goodness. Well,
look by your neighbor, say neighbor. Me look like me I hide from you. Me look like me I block you. Look like me I dodge you. After me I have nothing to fear. When I think of the goodness of Jesus and what he has done for me, my soul, look at your neighbor, say, give me pass, let me praise God in our church. Because I feel like I feel like the windows are open. I feel my blessing coming down. Back off. Anybody want to stop it? If you think you're bad, stop heaven from open. Stop my heaven. You can't stop it. Look at your neighbor, say, you can't do nothing to stop it. I paid my dues. I gave my offering. I sowed my seed. Now I'm reaping my abundance. Excuse me. You talkers, you accusers, you watchers, you criticizers, you mongers, get on my back, you monkeys, hop off my fender. I'm too blessed to be stressed. I'm too anointed to be, I feel something. Let me go, no man. Give me pass. Make me praise me, God. Because when I feel something here. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout God. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I'll say of the Lord, he is my provider, my deliverer. When everybody walked out, he never leave me nor forsake me. When anybody backed out and leave me all alone, he sat with me. He comfort me. He strengthen me. And now, excuse me, let me shoot out. I was buried alive, but I'm still breathing. My heart beating. I feel the Holy Ghost. Buried in hell, but I'm coming out. I follow the principle. I paid my tithes, and look what the Lord has done. Somebody give him a praise here. Lift up the name of. Shout something here. Give him praise. Stop, rob God. Pay your dues. You'll never be the same. May not happen overnight. Rome never built in a day. Tree take a while to grow. So don't run, leave God. Because it's not an overnight thing. You have to be patient. You have to wait for that tree to grow. If it's a coconut tree, sometimes it takes so long to even put on one leaf. But you're still going to get coconut some years down the line. Invest in the kingdom and watch God build. Your resources are blessing. It's coming back at you. Press down, shaken together, and running over. You will not have room enough to receive it. I'm closing. Maybe tomorrow I'll talk, but I feel the anointing. Somebody give him a praise. Somebody worship the Lord. Shout hallelujah. Give him praise here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Begin your tithing. Pay your tithes for the year. It will surely help you in your life. Somebody praise him here. Change your attitude. Change your mindset. And begin to release. And watch God transform, renew, revive, refresh your life. Can I go a little further and close? A few more minutes. Tithers cause the open heaven to open over their lives. And the open heavens mean that you will be called a delightsome stone, a delightsome land. Paying of your tithes cause a blessing to be poured out on you, and one of the effects of that blessing is that you will be called a delightful land. You will be attractive and bring pleasure to people. You will be attractive to others. Huh? And you'll be able to make others benefit through you and from you. When you're a delightful land, you provide food for others. You don't go begging. People come to you. Did you hear that? How many of you want to be in that place? All the nations shall call you blessed, for ye shall be a delightful land, said the Lord of hosts. Chapter 3, verse 12. A delightful land means you're producing delightful crops. So people are always reaping from you, off you. I don't want to reap off people. I want people to reap off me. That means I'm the one with the blessing. Are you there? Are you ready to go home for rice and peas now? Number 7. Tithers cause the heavens to be open over their lives. And the open heaven means that you will be blessed to see visions of God. Oh, I love this one. Can I end on that one? Now, it came to pass in 30th year, in the fourth month, in the fifth day of the month, as I was among the captives by the river of Siba, that the heavens were open and I saw visions of God. Ezekiel 1 verse 1. Ezekiel 1 verse 1. Let's go again. Now it came to pass in the 30th year, in the fourth month, in the fifth day of the month, as I was among the captives, the what? I was among the captives. So you can live among the captives, but being blessed by God, even though you're among people that are in captivity. Because you're different. God knows you. God chose you. And even in the midst of trials, tribulation, he will send vision and speak to you. Nowadays, I've been saying, Lord, talk to me. Huh? When the heavens were open, Ezekiel saw visions of God. But how is it? How is the paying of tithes connect to the seeing of visions? Most people do not connect the paying of tithes with the seeing of vision. But paying of your tithes caused the heavens to be open, and the opening of the heavens caused you to see the visions of God. God begin to show you things clearer. Begin to show you things you never see. By just paying your tithes. All that you're praying about, God can show you. All that is happening to you, God can show you. All people are trying to do to you, God will show you. You're not talking to me. God will open the vision. Open your eyes to see things. And when you see them, you know it's God. Huh? You don't get it yet. Visions can change your life permanently. One of the little known blessings of tithes is to see visions. My life has been blessed greatly by the vision of God has given me, and I recommend that you pay your tithes so that the heavens will be open and you will begin to see visions of God. God begin to open things before your eyes. Show you clear visions. Hallelujah. Tithers cause the heavens to be open over their lives, and the open heaven means that the Holy Spirit will be openly manifested in your life. Watch this one. Sit down tight. What time is it? To 2. I got until 2 o'clock. Are you ready to go? Okay. This one is big. Means that the Holy Spirit will be openly manifested in your life. Openly. Manifestation of the Holy Spirit is powerful. When the Holy Spirit begins to manifest in your life, through your life, and out of your life, is a powerful thing. You're not talking to me. Oh, you're hungry, boy. Then cometh Jesus from Galilee to Jordan, unto John, to be baptized of him. But John forbade him, saying, I have need to be baptized of thee, and cometh thou to me. And Jesus answered and said unto him, suffer it to be so now, for this thus becoming it, us to fulfill all righteousness. Then he suffered him. And Jesus, when he was baptized, went up straightway out of the water, and lo, the heavens were. See how many times in the Bible he talks about the open heavens? And unto him. And he saw the Spirit of God descend like a dove and lightning upon him. Open? Okay. Hallelujah. Matthew 3:13-17 for those who are writing. Matthew 3:13-17. When there is an open heaven, the Holy Spirit is poured out on you. When you pay your tithes, the Holy Spirit will begin pouring upon you because of the open heavens. You will have the spirit of wisdom, knowledge, understanding, mighty counsel and counsels. You will have the helper in your life. Everybody say, I need a helper in my life. I'm not talking the helper that washes your clothes and clean your floor now. Your spirit helper will show up with an open heaven. Hallelujah. All of the blessing of the coming of the anointing will be your portion because of the open heaven over you. So you think is Reverend Stewart must pray your way through everything. And some of you vex because you can't get my number if you call me for them to pray 3 times a day for you. And you can't meet with me in the office every minute for tell me your problem and beg me for prayer. What kind of pastor? Jody, Evangelist, when can I meet with Rev? I need to meet Rev and tell him, oh, Rev is not available. I can't bother with that. I'm kind of too busy for me. Go on next church where pastor have time. Yeah. When last you met with God? Because if you ever met with God, you really don't need me. Every believer must try to meet with God. Because if you ever meet with God, you come show off on me. Pastor, I met with God. I'm blessed. I don't need you. I ain't coming to your office. So I don't see you. But since I met God, Pastor, here's my tithes. Here's my Pastor, what do you want to do for the church? I can bless you. Because I met with God. Everybody wants to meet Pastor. Who wants to meet God? Everybody wants to burden me with all your problems. Do you know I can't manage all of it? But if God sees all of you coming, he can meet with all of you and supply all your need. Because if you meet with me, I will still have to pray to him for you. But if you meet with him, hi. What if I meet with you and you ask me to meet with God and God don't want to meet with me? What if God don't want to hear me on your behalf? What if in fact he really wants to hear from you? Huh? See, some of you just love the third party. I love direct deposit. Am I talking to you today? When I get like this, you must be blessed. If you plan to go another church, you change your mind today. This teaching alone holds you. And say amen if you agree.
Amen.
Somebody don't agree. Hallelujah. Ninthly, tithing caused the open heaven to open over their life. And the open heaven means that you will see the glory of God in your life. My God. You will see the vision of God. Huh? You'll see the Holy Spirit descending. And now you will see the glory. Everybody say, I want to see the glory. But he, being full of the Holy Ghost, looked up steadfast into heaven and saw the glory of God and Jesus standing at the right hand of God. And he said, behold, I see the heavens open and the Son of Man standing on the right hand of God. Acts chapter 7, 55 and 56. That's Stephen when he was being stoned. And even when people are stoning you, you see the glory. That's the problem some people really have with you, you know. All this stone where them are dash upon you, all you're doing is looking at the glory. Oh, you're not, they don't get it, you know. I say, all the stones that are being thrown at you, you ain't paying them no mind because you're looking up and the heaven is open and you're seeing the glory. They can't get rid of you. There's too much glory shining. Somebody smile a while, give your face a rest. Why are you making up your face in here this morning? Rest your face. Gaze into the glory of God with all the stone they're throwing at you. I'm closing. It's coming down. I want to go. Hallelujah! The tides open the windows of heaven. And when the windows of heaven are open, the glory of God pour out on your life. The glory of God speak of the beauty of the Lord. And if God beautify you and all that you are, you will be truly beautiful. Don't let nobody have to tell you now. Can you see it in you? Can you see the glory? Do you know the glory? Have you experienced the glory? Look in the mirror again. The glory of God is shining on you. Oh, hallelujah! The glory of God is different from the glory of man. Oh, I need to go there. I said the glory of God is different from the glory of man. The glory of man is temporary when they see you and want something from you. The glory of God is when you pay your dues and he fulfills everything in your life and just overshadow you with his... There are some people you have to do something to get something. You have to prove your love and prove your worth to them before they can love you and bless you. Hello! Hallelujah. Man is attracted to the outward appearance, but God has things that attract him. A meek, humble, and a quiet spirit is precious to the Lord. A meek, humble, and quiet spirit on a top. Tell people, say them not anointed, because they not jump up and down and carry on like you. Hey, amen, a little bit there, so. Just because you not run up and down and wash floor and carry on, some people say, nah. Somebody just get liquor, who? Nobody no ball out. They are squeezing. God loves a meek, humble, and quiet spirit. And precious is to the Lord. But don't take my meekness and my kindness for weakness. Because if you try war me, I'm a complaint to God about you. You're just dead. Because the battles that I cannot fight, I give them to the Lord. So I'm going to remain humble, meek, and trust in God to fight my battle. You're just dead. Hallelujah. When the glory of the Lord is upon you, a scenery, a heavenly beauty will descend on your life. People will look at you and say, boy, you just look sweet. You just look beautiful. You just have glow. And you know, do not, you know. It just come natural. I'm sure if me run a scan upon you, you know, I've done no Chinese makeup. You ever see some people when they're fully make over? And you have to look and say, are you? When some people look upon you, they don't have to guess if are you. Them know say are you. But they just see a more beautiful you. I've looked at people on picture and didn't recognize who they are. And say, who are you again? And say, oh, shame on you. You don't know who I am. I say, no, you look different. Because they have an artificial makeover. When God begins to bless you, you don't need an artificial makeover. An artificial makeover, I'm not even just talking about makeup on your face. Generally in your life. Nothing that you have will be artificial. Everything that God blesses you with will be authentic. Not made in China. Nico, where are you? I said not made in China. God will never give you things made in China. No, God will give you things made in America, England, Germany, or Russia. Hallelujah. These people, what? Russian vehicles, Russian things are authentic. They're strong. They're strong like Putin. You see what was it? Last one, number 10. And we're closing. Tithing caused the heavens to be open over their lives in the open heaven, meaning that you will see Jesus. I thought the church was excited. I said, finally, you will be able to see Jesus. But he, being full of the Holy Ghost, looked up steadfast in heaven and saw the glory of God and Jesus standing on the right hand of God and said, behold, I see the heavens open and the Son of Man standing on the right hand of God. And once you're seeing Jesus, tell some people, don't trouble me now. Because as long as I'm seeing Jesus, it means he's close. When the windows of heaven opened, Stephen saw Jesus standing by the right hand of God. But what is the connection between Jesus appearing to you and the paying of your tithes, you may ask? Is the paying of your tithes a gate fee that gives you access to Jesus? Answer for yourself. Is your gate pass to Jesus? One of your gate paths to Jesus is to be faithful and pay in your tithe. No! The tithe is not a gate fee, brothers. Sorry to disappoint you. No, it's not. But it has the effect of opening the windows of heaven to your life. You don't need a gate pass and a gate fee. Because when the windows open, you have access freely. You don't have to show nobody nothing. You don't have to prove nothing to nobody. It will all happen for you. Give God the praise. Give God the praise. When the windows of heaven are open over your life, you can expect to see Jesus just as Stephen did. One of the greatest blessings you could ever have is for Jesus to appear to you. The church, you don't have these experiences. That's why the Christian life is boring. If you ever see Jesus face to face, you never want to stop seeing him. So you will do everything in your power to always see him. Hello! Some of you in church from Wapiki, feel like you never see Jesus. You never experience an open heaven. You never experience what it is like to be blessed and say, God is good, sir. You have never put yourself in that place. and in that position to experience it. And remember now, as the Spirit tells me, this one is too big. Stephen was being stoned when he saw the heavens open and he saw Jesus. Don't think it's only in your good moments that you're going to experience Jesus. In the darkest hours of your life and the lowest moment, when the stones are meant to kill you, that when heaven opened and Jesus present himself and declare, I am with you. Oh, somebody don't hear that. I said, while they stoned him, he saw the heavens open. And he said, I see Jesus. All Jesus wanted to do in your darkest and most terrible moment is to see him. Oh God, this sermon here today. I say, all God wants you to do when you're going through your fire is to see Jesus. That he's right there with you. And then you just lift your hand and say, I know that I can make it. I know that I can stand. So no matter what may come my way, Let me close this. Aye. Since then, I long to see Jesus. I long to see him. I want him to appear to me and speak to me. Anybody want that? I want him to tell me whether I am doing the right thing or not. But such a blessing is not easy to acquire. I realize that. Me can tell you. It takes the heavens being open. I feel so encouraged to find out that paying tithes can open the heavens over your life. And I feel so blessed to be able to pay my tithe. I want to pay more tithes. Everybody say, I want to pay more tithes. Because I want more windows to open. I want the open of the windows of heaven over my life. I want to see Jesus. I want to see the glory. I want to experience the presence. I want the Holy Spirit to descend upon me like a dove. How do you achieve all of that? Paying your tithes. Giving God yourself. One tenth of your life, of your service, of your resources, of your time, of your talent, of your substance. And God will open the windows, pour you out a blessing that you will not have room enough to receive it. Are you ready for it? Pay your tithes. Pay your tithes. Everybody get ready. I think I left my nose. Let me greet the household of faith and all the worshipers that have come to celebrate God on today. Let me greet our pastor, Pastor Lawrence, her husband and children and leaders, and of course our young people, Joshua Generation. And our young adults are in action today. It's very good to see that we are moving in a positive way as we seek to build our youth, the future of the church. And I love young people. I love old people and middle-aged folks. I love everybody. I'm a lover of people. Even though sometimes people don't love me. But I love people. And I love to see people life and purpose come to life. And I love to watch people grow and develop into their full potential. And whatever I can do to help people become better, then we'll have less bitter people on the earth. Amen. So I thank God for our missionary, Jody, and her vision. And now we see why these people have been elevated, because they got purpose to lead and to make things happen in the church. And that's the thing about me, that I love to give people the opportunity to manifest their gifting and their calling. If some of us would just allow people to grow and allow people to do what they're called to do, then we'll see much more coming out of people. I want the inclusiveness and I want the involvement. And so those who are not a part of a ministry, I see the women's ministry under the new leadership of Sister Marcia is doing great. And those who have not yet come to join these ministries, please come and join. We have shift leadership. There's so much going on. I'm telling you, it's excited and it's awesome. We have met as the men's group. Also, we want to take the opportunity to invite those men who have not yet been a part of the men's fellowship. They're now under new leadership. Our evangelist, Nico, is now the new leader for the men's group, men's fellowship. Our brother Coleman, our deputy leader. Amen. Praise God. Young, dynamic, and powerful young man to lead on the church. Yes, give them a hand. Give them a hand. So, I'm doing a lot of work, putting things into perspective in place here in Mandeville. Because none of you will write the piece of paper and saying, I'm not doing anything. Amen. So I'm leading from the front and I'm putting the church in order. If you don't want to, I told you long since when I came here, anyone who don't want to follow the order of leadership and of moving this church forward, then, I'm telling you, I will leave that. And I did promise you a pastor to assist in ensuring, and now it's going to blow up even more because it's not one, it's two of us. And we've done a great job in Hudspen together, working there and building there and making things happen. And I know it's going to happen here. Are you ready? Are you excited? So I want you all to become excited about Mandeville, because I'm here to make Mandeville what it was supposed to be and intended to be, the mother of breakthrough. Some people have tried to change that and break that down, and I'm back to fix it, because this is where we start. And no church, other one as big as Port Maurice, Hunspin, this church, we started here, and we're going to build here, and grow here, and do well here. Amen? Anybody who's not a part of this movement here, then find somewhere else. Literally. But we're going to do this together. Amen? Fellowship will be the order of the day. Working together and building together is going to create an atmosphere where we will not have place for people like we did together. Myself, Reverend Thames in Portmore. We're going to do it here as we did in Hunspen. I see like I'm the move around. I'm the one to go around and bring energy and bring synergy and things to the church. That's why they call me They call me so much name. Amen. But I've been trained for it. I love it. And I love to serve the Lord. And that's what I'm going to do. Before I do offering, I want to do the word, because I want to make some people feel bad and change their mind and give right. So let's get into the word. Those who were here on Sunday gone, we started on Monday, was excellent. It was here on Monday. And one of the things that I keep saying to you people, if you don't like Monday prayer meeting and Bible study, you're not a good Christian. You got to push. You got to push. I want to see more of you coming out to pray. This is not service Sunday morning. I see so many of you that I've never seen. As I said before the other day, I really sat and watched and said, wow, why are these people not pushing to be in prayer meeting? prayer meeting and to study the word. So I'm encouraging all of you, amen, that can come to the eatings and the niceness and the other things. Come to church on a Monday. It's yours. For the word, that's where you grow. As we pray together, study the word together, we grow together. So I want to see much more people out on a Monday afternoon. Amen. Praise God. And then for the rest of the week, the only thing you are engaged to come to if it's your group meeting, like the men or the women. Apart from that, the rest of evening is your evening off. Okay? Huh? So Sunday morning, Monday evening, and the next one should be whichever one of the group you're a part of. So at least 3 times for the week you're supposed to be in church. Promise yourself. Convince yourself. Tell yourself. At least 3 times for the week. I need to be in church. Huh? Huh? Oh boy, I tell you. See? That's why it's hard. Because you're not agreeing. You're not convincing yourself that you need to be in the presence of God. And so, hear what you're doing. You're robbing God of his time when you're not interested to be in his house. How tithers open the heavens over their lives. How does the tither opens the heaven over their lives? Do you want to know? Huh? You got your pen and paper? Amen. He's not jumping up and down Sunday. So all who come for prance and jump, sit tight. Get your pen and papers up. Let's teach. Let's teach. A lot of times we come hooping and jumping and by jumping you go home, you don't get nothing. This is not something we hoop about. This is something we teach. So, amen. How tithers open the heavens over their life. Do you know what it means for the heavens to be open over your life? Think about it for a minute. Number one, the tither caused the heaven to be open over their lives. So it's not God who decides, I'm going to open the heaven over your life. You, the tither, you and I, huh? Causes the heavens to be open by your tithing. What does the word says? Malachi 3:10. Bring ye all the tithes into the what? The storehouse, that there may be meat in my house. And prove me now herewith, saith the Lord of hosts. Here is it. If I will not open the windows of heaven and pour you out a what? A blessing, that there should not be room enough to receive it. Hallelujah. Let's look at that. Bring your tithes into the storehouse. Hallelujah. That there may be meat in my house. And I told you last week, and I asked you, where is the house? Where's God's house? Huh? Right here. You show it like you're not sure. This is the house of God. This is the collection center. Hallelujah. This is the altar. So this is the place where you now make the sacrifice. So you bring it into the house of the Lord, that I may have in my house. Huh? And then here God says, prove me. I'm appalled now and surprised that God would say that. God is saying to you, you can prove him. Because his words are secure and sure. It's not a guessing thing. It's not like the government. You're not sure if they're here or there because they keep changing. Hallelujah. He never changes. And so he said, you can prove me and see, watch this now. Here's the promise. If I will not, I didn't say Reverend Stewart now. God himself says you can prove him and see if he will not open the windows, with an S, windows of heaven. Anybody, the last time you check Revelation, you should go and look how big heaven is.
Bless the name of the living God, my Father. What a great release. What a great message coming at you. I know you're blessed. I know right now many of you are thinking about it. And of course, in that message, I declared, listen, if you stop rob God, you got to know that your life will never be the same. If God has blessed you, you've got to obey his word. You've got to do what you're asked to do in order for the next level of blessing to come on your life. This is no joke, folks. God says, yes, you have robbed me with your tithes and offering. Guess what? You are cursed with a curse. And of course, the enemy will come in. But the Lord says, I will stop them. I will curse them for you. But you don't want to be cursed. You want to be blessed. So whatever it takes for you to be blessed, including giving God your one-tenth, your tithe, and ensure that a blessing come at you, you got to do it today. He says the windows of heaven. Listen, heaven has many windows. And today we want to pray that any one of those windows can open in your favor. Father, in the name of Jesus, as your people have heard this divine word, I pray, God, for miracles, signs, and wonders. But I pray that your people will obey your word and do what is necessary to receive the open heaven blessing. Mighty God, heal and deliver. Set the captive free. Right now, in the name of Jesus, deliver the sick, raise the dead, bring glory to your name. Touch our Highland home, our Highland Jamaica. Deliver us from the evil. Deliver us from the murder. Deliver us from the accidents. Deliver us, amen, from the corruption. Mighty God, help us in this land, eternal Father, and give us a new day, a peaceful day, and a blessed week in Jesus' mighty name. May God bless you today as we continue to serve and to do his will. Here on earth, remember, you have a responsibility to make sure you do what God asks you to do. Don't be a robber, be a tither. God bless you. God be with you. Until next week, we'll come in with another series right here at Breakthrough Mandeville. Yes, we want to take this opportunity to invite 1,000 Jamaicans to join us. Portmore St. Catherine, 18 West Tradeway, Portmore Town Center. Mega convention. Easter Monday, the 18th of April, 9:30 a.m. I want you to come on out as we pray for Jamaica, land we love. Too much crime, too much murder, too much corruption. We've got to seek God. If my people who are called by my name humble themselves and pray, I will heal the land. Come on out and join us, Jamaica, 1,000 strong, to pray over the nation. It's another ball out. Easter Monday, the 18th of April, Breakthrough Deliverance Ministry, Portmore. Will you be there? Looking forward to seeing you.